प्लस सेंट इज इक्वल टू परसेंटेज पर मींस फॉर एवरी सेंट मींस सेंचुरी दैट इज 100. सो व्हेन परसेंटेज इज कैलकुलेटेड फॉर एनी वैल्यू इट मींस दैट यू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू फॉर एवरी 100 ऑफ द रेफरेंस वैल्यू. सो व्हेन यू सी द वर्ड परसेंट और द सिंबल परसेंटेज रिमेंबर इट मींस 1/100. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू कैन टेक दैट इज 20%. 20% is equal to 20 divided by 1/100, that is equal to 50. So percentage, you know, it means always it shows like that is 100. So this is an introduction about the percentage. What do you mean by the percentage, the definition? So when a percentage is calculated for any value, it means that you calculate the value for every 100 of the reference value. When you see the word percent or a symbol, that is 1/100. Students, you have to know why the percentage concept that is evolved in the platform or a comparison of various things. Because the percentage is a concept evolved so that there you can be a uniform platform for comparison of various things, since each value is taken to a common platform of 100. So that is the concept for the percentage. Let's see the detailed concept. By a certain percent, we means that many hundreds will be there, and then we have to find out the percentage. Let's see the next slide. So by a certain percent, we mean that many hundreds. So to express x percentage as a fraction, we have x percentage is equal to x divided by 100. For example, we can take it as a 20%. That means 20 divided by 100 is equal to 1/5. For example, you can take it for 48%. That means 48 divided by 100 is equal to 12/25. So to express, for example, a by b as a percent, we have a by b is equal to a divided by b into 100%. Thus 1/4, we have taken as a fraction of 1/4. So 1/4 into 100 is equal to 25%. So even we can take it as a fraction, we can take it as a whole number, we can take it as a decimal number, we can convert it into percentage. Here for an example, we have 0.6. That means 6/10 is equal to 3/5. So 3/5 you can convert it into percentage. Thus you have to multiply into 100, that is 60%. So this is the concept of percentage. We can convert it into percentage by a number or whole number or a number or a fraction or decimal. We can be converted into percentage. Next one, we have a commodity price increase or decrease. The formula, what is the formula we can be used? So if the price of a commodity increases by R percentage, then the reduction in consumption so as not to increase the expenditure is. So R by 100 plus R into 100%. If the price of the commodity decreases R percentage, then to maintain the same expenditure by increasing the consumption is R divided by 100 minus R into 100%. So what is the formula for the increase by R percentage, and what is the formula for commodity decreases by R percentage? So the reduction in consumption as not to increase the expenditure is R divided by 100 plus R into 100%. So if the commodity decreases by R percentage, then to maintain the same expenditure by increasing the consumption is R divided by 100 minus R into 100%. So what is the formula to find out the percentage that results in population? So let the population of the town or a city or a group of places be that is a P now, and then suppose it increases the rate of R percentage per annum. Then so here the P denotes as population. So let the population of the town be P now, and suppose it increases at the rate of R percentage per annum, then population after n years is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power of n, and population n years ago P is divided by 1 plus R by 100, the whole power of N. So these are all the two formulas, population after N years, and then population N years ago. So we are discussing the concept and then that is a formulas that is based on to find out the concept of percentage and the what is the formula for commodity price and then decrease students. And we have discussed the formula for how to solve the problem to find out the population based on problem. We can use the formula population after N years and then population N years ago. Next one, the next formula, the how to find out the percentage, the problem they will give you based on results on depreciation. So what is that is the results on depreciation. So let the present value of a machine be P. Suppose it depreciates at the rate R percentage per annum, then the value of machine after N years is equal to P into 1 by R by 100, 1 minus R by 100 into whole power of N. So if the value of machine N years ago, so there we have taken the previous one, the formula, results on population, population after N years, students, and then population N years ago. So population after N years, the formula is P into 1 plus R divided by 100 whole power of N. I told you what is P, population, and the R percentage, that is rate of R percentage per annum. Population N years ago is equal to P divided by 1 plus R divided by 100 whole power of N. So here we are discussing the formula, the percentage to find out the results on depreciation. So let the present value of a machine, that is BP, suppose it depreciates at the rate R percentage per annum. Third formula, if A R percentage more than B, then B is less than A by R divided by 100 plus R into 100 percentage. If A R percentage less than B, then B is more than A. So R divided by 100 minus R into 100 percentage. So we have of a four formulas, that is depreciation. Value of machine after N years is equal to P into 1 minus R by 100 into whole power of N. Value of machine N years ago is equal to P divided by 1 minus R by 100 whole power of N. So if A is R percentage more than B, then B is less than A by R divided by 100 plus R into 100 percentage. If A is R percentage less than B, then B is more than A by R divided by 100 minus R into 100 percentage. Next one, we'll see how to convert percentage into decimal, students, and percentage into fraction, and decimal to percent, and fraction to percent. So quickly we can see, so how to convert percent to decimal. So move the decimal point two places to the left. For example, we have 42%. We can move the decimal point two places to the left. That means 0.42. If we have that is percentage, like example as 55%, that means 0.55. You have to move the decimal point two places to the left. Next one, percent to fraction. Place the percent number in the numerator and 100 in the denominator. Simplify. For example, 42% or 35%. So here we have the numerator is 42 divided by 100 is denominator. So we get the answer 42 divided by 100. You can simplify it. We get for 42%, 21 divided by 50. So this we can give some other example, students, like 78%. So 78 divided by 100, we get simplified, we get the answer. So you can easily simplify according to your that is a quick solving the problems based on what questions they are asking. So next one, to how to convert percent to fraction. So place the percent number in the numerator, and then this we have discussed. The next one, decimal to percent. move decimal point two places to the right. For example, decimal, where they are giving the decimal, that you have to be converted into percentage. 1.6, that is equal to 160. In case 1.85, how to convert decimal to percent? Just move decimal point two places to the right, you get the answer 185 percentage. The last one, fraction to percent. First convert fraction to decimal, then follow the directions to convert from decimal to percent. For example, 5 divided by 6 is equal to 0.833. That can be is equal to 83. And also we can similarly, you can go for, that is the 1.8 percentage. So how to convert percent to decimal, percent to fraction, decimal to percent, and then fraction to percent. Next we have percentages, that is a fraction conversions. So percentage they have given here, and then decimal, and then fraction. So if you take it for 10%, what will be the decimal? We have a 0.1 decimal, fraction 1/10. Similarly, we have 12.5%, that is 0.125, fraction is 1 divided by 8. Similarly, we have 166%, so 0 point, after the decimal that moves as the right places, so 1666, and then fraction 1 divided by 6. Similarly, we have 20%, 25%, 30%, 33.33%, 40, 50. Similarly, we can convert it into decimal as well as fraction. So before the slide, students, we have discussed how to convert percent to decimal, percent to fraction, decimal to percent, and fraction to percent. We'll see the next slide. So converting decimals. So we can go for converting decimals more than one from the knowledge of above. That is the conversions as follows. So we know that 12.5% is equal to 0.125. That will be divided. That will be in the form of fraction 1/8. So then 1.125 is equal to 8 into 1 plus 1 divided by 8. That means 9/8. So the denominator will add to the numerator once, and the denominator remaining the same. So that is, the denominator will add to the numerator, and then denominator remaining the same. That means 8 plus 1 is equal to 8 into 1, that is 8 plus 1, 9 divided by 8. Also we have another example, that is 2.125 is equal to 8 into 2, 8 2 is 16 plus 1 divided by 8, 17/8. Here the denominator is added to the numerator twice, so that is the 17.8, 17 divided by 8. Similarly, we have 3.125 is equal to 8 3 is 24. Okay, so plus 1, 25 divided by 8, and so on. So the denominator will add to the numerator once, the denominator remaining the same for the first one. And also we have here the denominator is added to the numerator twice, we are getting the answer 17.8. Thus we can derive the fractions for decimals more than one by using less than one. Example, what is 62.5% of 320? So 5/8 divided by 320. So you know 62.5 is divided by is equal to, percentage is equal to 5 divided by 8. So answer will be 400. Very simplified and very easy to understand how to convert in decimals, fraction, and then percent, decimal to percent, and fraction to percent. So important points for the that is a percentage. When any value increases by 10%, it becomes 1.1 times of itself. That means 100 plus 10 is equal to 110%, that is equal to 1.1%. Similarly, 20%, it becomes 1.2 times of itself. And 36%, it becomes 1.36 times of itself. And then 4%, it becomes 1.04 times of itself. So thus we can see the effects on values due to various percentage increases. When any value decreases, similarly we have to subtract subtracting the 10. Okay, so when any value increases, the addition will take place. Where any value decreases, subtract will take place. Here, the similarly, value decreases, the 10%, it becomes 0.9 times of itself. So 100 minus 10 is equal to 90%. That means 0.9%, 9%, 0.9. So 20%, it becomes 0.8 times of itself. 36, it becomes 0.64 times of itself. Similarly, 4%, it becomes 0.96 times of itself. Thus, we can see the effects on a value due to various percentage increases. When a value is multiplied by a decimal more than 1, it will be increased, and when multiplied by less than 1, it will be decreased. So this is the main important rule. That is the important rule. Please understand, students, when a value is multiplied by a decimal more than 1, it will be increased. When the value multiplied by less than 1, it will be decreased. The percentage is mainly depends on the value increases or decreases, depends on decimal multiplied. That's a very important note. Students, when the percentage increases or decreases, depends on the decimal multiplier. We'll go for the next slide. Let's see the problems. So very simple problems for aptitude exam they will ask you. The only thing you have to remember the formulas what we have discussed from the previous slides. First question, A's salary is 50% more than B's. How much percent is B's salary less than A's? So options they are given here, 33 1/4%, option B 33 1/3%, and C 33 1/2%, and D 33%. Let salary of B be rupees 100. So salary of A is equal to 150% of rupees 100. That is equal to rupees 150. So how much percent B salary less than A's? So A salary minus B salary divided by A's salary into 100. So 50 divided by 150 into 100 is equal to 33 1/3%. So the B salary is less than A's. So the answer will be option B is the right answer, 33 1/3%. So you are subtracting A salary minus B salary divided by A salary. So here we have given, so the salary of A is equal to 150 of rupees 100. So rupees 150, then we have to convert into multiply into 100. So 50 minus 150 into 100, we get 33 1/3%. Option B, right answer for this question, students. So next question, evaluate 28% of 400 plus 45% of 250. So options A 220.3, B 224.5, C 190.3, D 150. So we can explain very simple easy method. 28% of 400 plus 45% of 250. Just you are dividing by 100 and multiplying into 400 and then 250, then adding the two values, you get the final answer. So 28 divided by 100 into 400, we are getting 112, plus we are 45 divided by 100, the answer multiplied by 250, you get the answer 112.5. So 112 plus 112.5, we are getting, if you add these two values, we get the answer 224.5. So option B is the right answer. So this is the answer for this question. Next question, Ramesh's salary was reduced by 10% and then reduced salary was increased by 10%. What was his ultimate loss? So option A 0%, option B 10%, option C 1%, and then D 5%. Let initial salary be rupees 100. Okay, we can assume the initial salary of rupees 100. So now salary was reduced by 10%. Just I told you, if you are reduced, you have to subtract. If it is increased, you have to add. So salary becomes 100 minus 10. 90% of 100. So salary of rupees 90. Now the salary was increased by 10%. Just you have to add 100 plus 10 is equal to 110% of 90. So salary will be rupees 99. So here the salary was reduced by 10%. The salary becomes rupees 90. Here the salary was increased by 10%, salary rupees 99. So formula loss percentage is equal to loss divided by initial salary into 100. So loss will be we having 1 divided by initial salary, we have assumed that rupees 100, that you are going to be multiplied with 100, that is the answer is 1%. So the ultimate loss, that is salary was increased and decreased, so the ultimate loss is C, option C, 1% is the right answer. So Ramesh salary was reduced by 10% and then reduced salary was increased by 10%. So what was his ultimate loss? His ultimate loss only 1%. Option C is the right answer. Next question. If two members are less than a third number by 30% and 37% respectively, how much percent is the second number less than the first? So A 7%, B 10%, C 4%, and D 3%. So the explanation, let the third number be 100. So the first number is 30% less than the 100. So 100 minus 30% of 100 is equal to 70. So 70, 100 minus 30% of 100 is 70. And second number is 37 less than 100. So 100 minus 37% of 100 is equal to 63. So now we have to find out how much percent is the second number less than the first number. So very simple, percentage less is equal to 70 minus 63 divided by 70 into 100. That means 7 divided by 70 into 100, 10%. So the how much percent is the second number less than the first, option B, 10% is the right answer. If x percentage of y is 100 and y percentage of z is 200, find the relation between x and z. So z is equal to x by 2 and b, z is equal to 2x, and c, x is equal to z by 4, d, z is equal to 4x. So please read the question twice or thrice, students, carefully. If x percentage of y is 100 and y percentage of z is 200, find the relation between x and z. So options, they are given four options. Let's see the explanation for this problem. So as per given condition, x divided by 100 into y is equal to 100. The same vice versa, y is equal to 100 into 100 divided by x. So y divided by 100 into z is equal to 200. So 100 into 100 into z divided by x into 100, that is equal to 200. So z is equal to 2x. So option B, right answer. So please read the question. They have given x percentage of y is 100 and y percentage of z is 200. So as per given condition, so we have to solve the problem carefully. Just you have to multiply 100 into 100 into z divided by x into 100, that is 200. So z is equal to 2x. Option B is the right answer, students. If 20% of an electricity bill is deducted, then rupees 100 is still to be paid. How much was the original bill? Options are A, rupees 110, and B, rupees 115, C, rupees 120, D, rupees 125. So explanation, so after 20% of electricity bill has been reduced or deducted, we still have to pay rupees 100. So remaining, so 100 minus 20 is equal to 80% of weight. That is equal to rupees 100. So 80 divided by 100 into the bill cost rupees is equal to 100. So bill is equal to rupees 125. Okay, so this is the answer. So the original bill, the amount is rupees 125. Option D is the right answer. A town population, a town has population of 50,000 in 1988. In 1 year, that is by 1989, it increased by 25%. Next year, in 1990, it decreased by 30%. The next year, in 1991, there was an increase of 40%. What is the population at the end of 1991? So we have given the very five digit answer numbers: A 60250, B 62250, C 66550, and D 61250. Let's see the problem how to solve. Please read the question once more. Students, a town has population of 50,000 in 1988. In 1 year, that is 1989, it increased by 25%. That means in the next year, in 1990, it decreased by additional 5%, that is 30% decrease. The next year, in 1991, there was an increase of 40%. So totally in the year of 1991, what is the population? The end of 1991. We'll see the explanation for this problem. So please remember the formula in the easy way. It is similar to the formula for compound interest. So population after n years is equal to e into 1 plus or minus r divided by 100 whole power of n, where p stands for present population, r stands for rate of increase or decrease, where n denotes the number of years. So plus sign which denotes during increases, negative sign, that is minus sign, decreases. Okay, so this is the formula for to find out the similar formula like compound interest. The population after n years and a population before year, that is n years ago, and then population after n years. So using the formula from the given above, rate 1 is equal to r1 is equal to 25% increases. And then you can read the question. Okay, so the rate 1, that is 25% increases in the year of 1989, and then rate 2, that is 30% decreases in the year of 1990. The next year, 1991, again it increases 40%. So we have to take it for the 3 years, that is 1988, 1989, and then 1991. So the population after 3 years is equal to 50,000 into 1 plus 25 by 100. And then, so I told you the decreases means negative sign, increases means plus sign. So here I am writing here 1 minus 30 divided by 100, and then 1 plus 40 divided by 100. So 50,000 into 125 divided by 100, and then 70 by 100, and 140 divided by 100. So the final answer is 61250 is the answer. Option D is the right answer for 7th question, students. The answer is 61250. So what is the population at the end of the 1991? Option D, 61250. Next question. In an election which contestant was two candidates, one of the candidates got 40% of total votes and then yet lost by 1,000 votes. What is the total number of votes casted in the election? So A, we have 10,000, B, 6,000, C, 8,000, D, 5,000. So what would be the explanation for this question? In election which contested was contested by two candidates, one candidate got total 40 votes and yet lost by 1,000 votes. What is the total number of votes casted in the election? So let us assume total votes is equal to A. This means votes of candidate 1 plus votes of candidate 2 is equal to A. So we know that votes of candidate first one, that is 40% of A, 40A divided by 100. So votes of candidates of 2 is equal to 100% minus 40% of A, that is 60% of A. So first candidate lost by 1000 votes is equal to difference of votes between both candidates. So 60A divided by 100 minus 40A divided by 100 is equal to 1000. So A is equal to 5000. Option D is the right answer. So votes of candidates of 1 is 40% of A, that means 40A divided by 100. Hence votes of candidate 2 is equal to 100% minus 40% of A is equal to 60% of A. So 60A divided by 100. So option A, that is option D, is the right answer. A is equal to 5000. In a class, 15% of total number of students failed in science, 25% of total number of students failed in math, and 10% of total number of students failed in both. How much percentage of students passed in both math and science? Options: 70%, B 80%, C 60%, D 90%. We'll see the explanation, students. So usually make mistake by the students, just they will percentage of students failing in both subjects, that is 25% plus 15% is equal to 40%. Okay, but as shown in the below diagram, the students who have failed both subjects 10% are counted twice minus once in 15%. So let's see the diagram. By drawing the diagram, you can easily understand and solve the problem. Students failed in science, that is 15%. This is in blue color. And then students fail in both science and math, that is equal to 10%. And then students failed in math, that is 25%. So we need to subtract this double counting. So students who failed in subjects could be 25% plus 15%, and then minus, that is students fail in both subject, just you have to minus 10%, that is equal to 30%. So please remember, subtract only once, not twice. So the percentage of students who passed in both subjects, 100 minus 30% is equal to 70%. So the students who fail subjects is 30%. That means the students who passed in both subjects, 100 minus 30% is 70%. So thus 70% passed in both subjects, that means science and math. So option A is the right answer. A man invests 1/3 of his income at 7%, 1/4 at 8%, and remainder of his income at 10%. If the annual profit is rupees 561, what was the initial capital? Rupees 75,000. 7,500, and then rupees 6,600, and rupees 4,500, D rupees 3,000. So let's see the initial amount. The initial amount that the man invests be A. So let X be the capital. So profit on first investment plus profit on second investment plus profit on third investment. So simple interest is equal to P into R into T divided by 100. P is a principal amount, R is a rate of annum, and T is a number of years, or we can write it N. So the remainder of capital is equal to 1 divided 1 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. So 5 by 12 x. So x being the capital. So we get the answer 561. So therefore, A is the right answer. A is equal to 6600. Option B is the right answer. Let's see the GATE previous questions for the topic, this topic percentage solved questions from the GATE. So there are two candidates P and Q in election. During the campaign, 40% of voter promised to vote for P and rest for Q. However, on the day of election, 15% of the voters went back on their promise to vote for P and instead voted for Q. 25% of voters went back on their promise to vote for Q and instead voted for P. Suppose P lost by 2 votes, then what was the total number of voters? So this question from they have asked GATE 2011 CEC department. So option A 100, option B 110, option C 90 and D 95. We'll solve the problem, students. Let total candidates be T. So the given 40% promise to P, remaining 100 minus 40 is equal to 60% promise to Q. So votes obtained by P is equal to 40% of T, that is 0.4T. So minus 15% of 40% of T, that will be went to Q. 15 divided by 100 into 0.4T is equal to 0.060. So plus percentage, that is a plus 25% of 60% of T came from Q is equal to 25 divided by 100 into 0.60 is equal to 0.15T. So 0.4T minus 0.060 plus 0.15T is equal to 0.490. This is for votes obtained for by P. So T, you know, total candidates. Votes obtained by Q is equal to 60% of T promised, that is 0.60. So minus 25% of 60% of T. So 25 divided by 100 into 0.66 is equal to 0.15T. Plus 15% of 40% of T is equal to 15 divided by 100 into 0.40 is equal to 0.060. So 0.60 minus 0.15T plus 0.060 is equal to 0.51T. So votes obtained by Q minus votes obtained by P is equal to 0.51T minus 0.490 is equal to 0.02T. So T is equal to 0.02 divided by 2 is equal to T is equal to 100. So option A, that is T is 100, is the right answer, students. Next question. The data given in the following data summarizes the monthly budget of an average household. This is another question for K 2012. They have given the category and amount for the food 4000, clothing 12,200, rent 2000, savings 1500 and other expenses 1800. The approximately percentages of the monthly budget not spent on savings is option A 10%, option B 14%, option C 81%, option D 86%. Total 100% is equal to 4000 for food, 1200 cloth, 2000 rent and 1500 savings and 1800 other expenses. Totally we have 10,500. Except saving 10,500 minus 1500. So total value, the total amount subtracting with minus of savings 1500 is equal to 9000. Percent of not saving is equal to 9000 divided by 10,500 into 100, that is equal to 85.17. So answer is exactly 86%. So option D is the right answer, 86%. The approximately percentage of monthly budget not spent on saving is 86%, or you can do the other method, percent of saving. We have taken here percentage of not saving. Here we can take percentage of saving is equal to 1500 divided by 10,500 into 100 is equal to 14.28, that is 14%. And then remaining percentage of not saving, that is 100% minus 14%, 86% option we have, that is D is the right answer. Next question. In a huge pile of apples and oranges, both ripe and unripe mixed to other, 15% are unripe fruits. Of the unripe fruits, 45% are apples, the ripe ones, 66% are oranges. If the pile contains a total of 569,200 fruits, how many of them are apples? So options are given in a very big values, the numbers. So let's see how to solve the problem. This could be feel like a tricky question, students, but it will be a very easy if you solve. Read question twice or thrice, then you can understand and you can solve the problem. Total fruits is equal to 569,200. We can divide it into ripe and unripe. So ripe we have 85%. Ripe we have of two fruits, apple 34% and oranges 66%. And unripe we have 15%. Totally 100% of fruits, apple 45% and orange 45%. Total number of apples is equal to ripe apples plus unripe apples. So 85% of ripe, of 34% of apple, and plus 15% of unripe, or 45% of apple. So see the question, they have asked how many there more apples. If the pile contains a total of 569,200 fruits, how many of them are apples? So we need to find out how many total number of apples. So how many of them are apples from ripe and unripe fruits? So 0.85 into 0.34 plus 0.15 into 0.45, that is into 569,200. So answer will be 2029198. So option A is the right question. So this is very easy, the question. Once you read, students, you are able to solve the problem. First, according to the question, you have to explanation should be written very clearly, to divide the total fruits into ripe and unripe, and then unripe, and then ripe apple and oranges. They are asked only how many of them are apples from the total of fruits. So option A is the right answer. Next question. Industrial consumption of power doubles from 2000 to 2001 to 2010 to 2011. Find the annual rate of increase in percentage, assuming it to be uniform over the years. So A, 5.6%, B, 7.2%, C, 10.0%, D, 12.2%. So we know total amount of is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 and N. P is a principal rate, R is a rate of annum, N is a total number of years. So, and it is given that industrial power is doubled from 2000 to 2001 to 2010 to 2011. So, N is equal to 10, A is equal to 2P. So, 2P is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100, 10 power of 10. So 2 is equal to 1 plus R by 100 power of 10. So 2 1 by 10 is equal to, if comes here the 10 power of 1 by 10, 1 plus R by 100. So 1.07177 is equal to 1 plus R by 100. So we get R is equal to 0.07177 divided by 100, you get 7.17 approximately. So R is equal to 7.2%. The annual rate of increase in percentage to be uniform over the years of 72%, 7.2% increases for the industrial consumption of power. So option B is the right answer. So that is 7.2% is the right answer. Next question. The radius as well as the height of a circular cone increased by 10%. The percentage increase in its volume is option A, 7.1%, option B, 21.0%, option C, 33.1%, option D, 72.8%. Let the radius and height of the cone be r and h respectively. So volume of the cone is equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. You know, everyone, the formula for volume of the cone is equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. The new radius of the cone is r plus 1 by 10 r is equal to 11 by 10 r. The height of the cone is h plus 1 by 10 h is equal to 11 by 10 h. So volume of new cone is equal to 1 by 3 pi into 11 by 10 r square, and then 11 by 10 h is equal to. So totally the volume of new cone is equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h, and then 11 by 10 cube. Percentage increase in volume of cone is equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h into 11 by 100 the whole power of 3 minus pi by 3 pi r square h divided by pi r 3 square h into 100. So we can take it as a common here, pi r 3 1 by 3 pi r square h into 11 by 100 whole power of cube minus 1 divided by pi 1 by 3 pi r square h into 100. So 11 by 10 cube minus 1 into 100 is equal to 1331 divided by 1000 minus 1 into 100. So we get 0.331 into 100, 33.1%. So option C, that is the right answer, 33.1%. Next question. A fruit seller sold a basket of fruits 12.5% loss. Had he sold it for rupees 108 more, he could have made a 10% gain. What is the loss in rupees incurred by the fruit seller? So this question, very recently, before 3 years, they have asked the GATE, that is Civil Engineering Department 2018, option 48, option B 52, option C 60, option D 108. So profit is equal to 10% X and loss is equal to 12.5% X. Let us assume X. So minus 12.5% plus 108 is equal to 10%. So 22.5 divided by 1000 of X is equal to 100. So 100 into 1000 divided by 225 is equal to X. So X is equal to 480. That means cost price X. Now loss we can find out from the cost price 12.5% of 480. So 125 divided by 1000 into 480 is equal to 60. So the loss rupees incurred by the fruit seller is only rupees 60 was loss. So option C is the right answer. Next question. In a country of 1,400 million population, 70% of own mobile phone among the mobile phone owners, only 294 million access the internet. Among these internet users, only off buy goods from e-commerce portals. What is the percentage of these buyers in the country? So this question they have asked in GATE 2019. Options 10.50%, B 14.70%, C 15.00%, D 50.00%. So total population of the country is equal to 1,400 million. The number of mobile phone users, 70% of total population is equal to 980 million. The number of internet users is equal to 294 million. So the number of e-commerce users, 1 by 2 into 9294 is equal to 147 million. So we have to find out how much percentage for the buyers in the country using online shopping. So 147 divided by 1400 into 100. So 10.5%. So option A is the right answer. The total population of the country is 1400 million. The number of mobile phone users equal to 70% of total population is equal to 980 million. Number of internet users equal to 294 million. Number of e-commerce users is equal to 1 by 2 into 294 is equal to 147 million. So option A is the right answer, 10.5%. Next question, 10 friends planned to share equally the cost of buying gifts for their teacher. When two of them decided not to contribute, each of the other friends had to pay Rs. 150 more. The cost of the gift was Rs. We have to find out. Let us consider cost of the gift will be X students. 10 friends contributes, then share is equal to X divided by 10. So two friends denying to contribute, then remaining are 8 each of remaining to be given Rs. 150 more. So read the question. When two of them decided not to contribute, each of the other friends had to pay Rs. 150 more. So we have to find out how much cost of the gift was Rs. by the shared by the friends. So X divided by 10 plus 150 into 8 is equal to X. So 8X divided by 10 plus 150 into 8X. So point X plus 150 into 8 is equal to X. So X is equal to 0.2 divided by 1200, that rupees of 6000 rupees. Option C, the cost of the gift was rupees 6000. 6000, option C is the right answer. Ninth question. A person divided an amount of rupees 1 lakh into two parts and invested in two different schemes. In one, he got 10% profit and in other, he got 12%. If the profit percentage are interchanged with these investments, he would have got Rs. 120 less. So find the ratio between his investments in two schemes. Option A, 9:16, B, 11:14, C, 37:63, D, 47:53. So let the amount of investment in first scheme is equal to X. Let the amount of investment in second scheme is equal to Y. So X plus Y is equal to 1 lakh. So let the profit of sum before interchanging percentage is equal to Z. So 110% X plus 112% Y is equal to Z. So 1.1X plus 1.12Y is equal to Z. After interchanging profit percentages, we can take it as an equation. This is 3. 1.1X plus 1.12Y is equal to Z minus 123. Subtracting equation 2 from equation 3, X plus Y is equal to 101 equation. And 1.1x plus 1.2y is equal to z is equation 2. And then 3 is 1.1x plus 1.2y is equal to z minus 120. So subtracting equation from 2 minus 3, 0.02x minus 0.02y is equal to minus 120. So x minus y is equal to minus 120 divided by 0.02 is equal to minus 6000. This is the equation. Subtracting equation 4 from equation 1, 2x is equal to 94,000. So x is equal to 47,000 and y is 1 lakh minus 47,000. We get y is equal to 53,000. So ratio between his investment 47,000 divided by 53,000, we get 47 divided by 53. If you take it this ratio investment in two schemes, we have the ratio of 47:53. So option D is the right answer. So the ratio between the investment in two schemes is 47:53 is the right answer. Next problem. Population of state X increased by X percentage and then population of X is increased by Y percentage from 2001 to 2011. Assume that X is greater than Y, let P be the ratio of population of state X to state Y in a given year. The percentage increases in P from 2001 to 2011 is. So this question they have asked from 2019 Civil Engineering Department. Option X by Y, B X minus Y, C 100 x minus y divided by 100 plus x and e 100 x minus y divided by 100 plus 5. So what would be the answer? Let's see. Let population of x is a in 2001 and population of y is b in 2001. So that is equal to a 1 plus x by 100, population of a in 2011, b into 1 plus y minus 100 of population b in 2011. So the given a by p is equal to p. So a 1 plus x by 100 for a and then 1x plus y by 100 divided by a by b into 100. The percentage increase in p by using the formula. P into 1 plus x by 100 divided by 1 plus y by 100 minus 3 divided by p into 100. So 1 plus x by 100 divided by 1 plus y by 100 minus 1 into 100 x minus y 100 divided by 100 plus 1. So option D is the right answer. So next question, the ratio of number of boys and girls who participated in an examination, 4 is to 13. The total percentage of candidates who passed the examination is 80 and percentage of girls who passed the exam is 90. The percentage of boys who passed is, in this question they have asked for two departments, K 2019 CS and Electrical Engineering, 90.00, 80.50, 55.50, 72.50. So the total candidate attempting the exam is 70. In this, boys, girls are in the ratio is 4:3. That means 40 boys and 30 girls. 80 of the total candidates pass the exam. That means 80 divided by 100 into 70, we get 56. The same like 90 of the girls pass the exam. 90 divided by 100 into 30 is equal to 77. So number of boys who pass the exam is equal to total candidates who pass the exam minus total girls who pass the exam. 56 minus 27 is equal to 29. The percentage of boys who pass the exam is equal to 29 divided by 40 into 100 is equal to 72.50. So option D is the right answer. Next question, the designer used marbles of four different colors for his designs. The cost of each marble is same irrespective of color. The table shows the percentage of marbles of each color used in the current design. The cost of each marble increased by 25%. Therefore, designer decide to produce equal number of marbles of each color to keep the total cost unchanged. What is the percentage of blue marbles in new design? A 2018, they have asked the question, Electrical Engineering Department, blue 40%, black 25%, red 20%, yellow 15%. Options are 43.7%, option B 40.15%, and then C 46.25%, and D 35.75%. You can assume total marbles equal to 100 and each, and the cost of each marble 1 rupees. To buy 100 marbles, designer need to spend 100 into 100 rupees. After increasing price cost of 100 marbles, rupees 125. So now about 100 rupees, the designer can buy 100 divided by 125 into 100 is equal to 80 marbles. The designer decided to reduce equal number of marbles of each color to keep total cost unchanged. So 40 minus x plus 25 minus x plus 20 minus x plus 15 minus x is equal to 80. So 4x is equal to 40, 100 minus 80. So x is equal to 5. The percentage of blue marbles in blue design is equal to 40 minus 5 divided by 80 into 100. So 35 divided by 80 into 100 is equal to 43.75%. Option A is the right answer. Students, last question. In a party, 60% of invited guests are male and 40% are female. If 80% of invited guests attended the party, if all invited female guests attended, what would be the ratio of males to females among the attendees in the party? Option E. This question they have asked in GATE 2018. 2:3, B 1:1, C 3:2, D 2:1. So let's total number of guests 100, 60 are male, 40 are female. but total guest attended all 40 female attended the party. So remaining 80 minus 40 attendees should be male. The ratio of male to female among attendees is 40:40. It means 1:1 ratio. Answer B is the right answer. Students, we have discussed all the problems with the formulas and also did solve the questions, more than 13 questions, solved the questions, very important topic, the percentage, which fetches the marks more than of 4 or 5 marks from the gate questions. So please understand the concept and please read the formulas and read the questions and practice regularly. So thank you so much. See you guys. Thank you, students.